In this chapter, we will learn about event transformer. A string can be converted to another string, as shown in the figure. For example, you can convert an existing string to a new string by multiplying all data by 2 or discarding even numbers. When processing an event in Bloc, how to handle the event may have various forms depending on the nature of the application. For example, there may be cases where the event received first must be processed first. In this case, if the processing of one event takes a long time, all subsequent events have to wait. This processing method is called sequential. This was a default handling method prior to Bloc 7.2. On the other hand, processing of events may not necessarily be done in order. In this case, the event is processed concurrently within the scope that can handle the event. However, if you do this, the processing result of the first received event may come later than the processing result of the second received event. However, this would be undesirable if the intent was to result in the second event handling later than the first. This is the current Bloc's default event handling method. This type of processing is called concurrent. Also, there may be cases where you are currently processing an event, and if another event is received, it may be desirable to discard a newly received event. For example, in the case of infinite scroll, new data is brought as soon as it exceeds the predetermined scroll height. Infinite scroll can be implemented in various ways, but it is meaningless to skip data and show it. In other words, in this case, it may be desirable to ignore the user's next scroll event. This method is called droppable. Also, when a new event comes in while processing the current event, it is sometimes desirable to discard the current event and process the new event. For example, when implementing traditional pagination, if you request the fifth page, as soon as you request the third page, it is preferable to drop the third page request and perform the fifth page request. This approach is called restartable. A package called Bloc Concurrency that supports these four types of event transformation was created by Felix Angelov, who is also the author of Flutter Bloc. And in order to reduce the amount of search when searching on a remote server, when the user stops typing for a certain period of time, for example, about 500 milliseconds, it is often implemented in a way that sends the search word entered by the user at once. This processing is called debounce. There are many other ways to convert an event to another stream. Handling incoming events in this way is called event transformation, and the processing function is called event transformer. And in Bloc, you can designate an event transformer for each event, or you can designate an event transformer for all blocs used in the app. Specifying an event transformer for every Bloc is the same as specifying a corresponding event transformer for every event transformer. And as in the case of Bloc overrides, you can also specify event transformers for each zone. To specify an event transformer for a specific event, you need to provide a custom event transformer. An event transformer takes an event stream and an event mapper, that is the event handler for that event, and returns a new event stream. Let's take a look through a simple app to see how a real event transformer affects the behavior of the app. I created an app called Event Transformer. As a package, I installed Equatable, Flutter Bloc, and Bloc Concurrency. And as in other apps, the include line of the analysis-option.yml file is commented out, and the default linting rule will not be applied during the development process. Let's take a quick look at the app. The app displays a current counter value in the middle of the screen, and there are two floating action buttons that increase by 1 when the plus button is pressed and decrement by 1 when the minus button is pressed. Since the app itself is an app that you have seen a lot, all the necessary functions start from the created state. This time, we'll focus on the effect of event transformation. First, let's take a brief look at main.dart. You injected the already created counter Bloc into the widget tree using the Bloc provider. Title was modified with event transformer, and debug banner was not displayed. The body of the scaffold is given a center widget, and the child is a text widget with font size 52.0. The text widget displays the state.counter value of a counter block instance accessed through a context.watch. In the first floating action button, the add method of a counter block instance is called through context.read. An increment counter event instance is given as an argument. In the second floating action button, the add method of a counter block instance is called through context.read, and an instance of a decrement counter event is given as an argument. And I created a counter block on the block folder. Let's start with the counter state.dart. The counter state is identical to the count state we created several times before, as you can see. Next, let's look at counter event.dart. I have created increment counter event and decrement counter event. Next, let's look at counter block.dart. Initial state replaced with counter state.initial factory constructor. I created an underscore handle increment counter event as an event handler for the increment counter event. As an event handler for the decrement counter event, I created an underscore handle decrement counter event. When the underscore handle increment counter event async function is called, it increments by 1 after waiting for 4 seconds. When the underscore handle decrement counter event async function is called, it waits for 2 seconds and then decrements it by 1. I ran the emulator for the test. First, let's press the plus button and then the minus button. Currently, because nothing is specified in the transformer or the onEvent API, it has concurrent behavior by default. However, since increment waits 4 seconds and decrement waits 2 seconds, minus 1 is displayed first and then 0 is likely displayed. Let's see if this actually happens. Minus 1 is displayed first, followed by 0. However, this concurrence is also applied to the same event. For example, if you make 2 consecutive requests for weather data to the remote API, there is no guarantee that the first request will be processed before the second request. This may cause the second request to appear first, followed by the first request. I'm going to press the minus button 3 times quickly here. After a while, you can see that minus 3 is displayed. Next, let's give droppable to the transformer of an on function that handles a decrement count event. Let's do a hard restart and test. Let's quickly press the minus button 3 times. This time, minus 1 is displayed. That is, any subsequent events that came in while processing the first event were discarded. Let's do a hard restart again and keep pressing minus 1 every half second. Minus 1 and minus 2 are displayed sequentially. Now, let's change droppable to restartable. Let's do a hard restart and run it. I'll keep pressing the minus button. As long as I keep pressing, I see that the number 0 doesn't change. In other words, when a new event comes in, the existing event is continuously canceled. So, this situation happened. Next, we'll apply a sequential transformer. Let's give sequential to the transformer of both on increment count event API and on decrement counter event API. Let's do a hard restart and test. What result do you expect? First, let's press the plus button and then the minus button. Minus 1 is displayed first, followed by 0. There seems to be no difference from the default behavior concurrent. Why? Each event has its own event bucket. Therefore, if sequential is given to the transformer, each event is processed sequentially in its own bucket, and multiple event buckets can be executed concurrently. To implement the behavior before version 7.2, you need to create a single bucket that can catch all the events in the block. Comment out the onIncrementCountEventAPI and onDecrementCountEventAPI, and create a catch-all event handler that can handle both incrementCountEvent and decrementCountEvent. Both incrementCountEvent and decrementCountEvent are subclass of countEvent. So, create an onCounterEvent API. Check the event type and call underscore handle increment counter event if the event type is increment counter event, and call underscore handle decrement counter event if the event type is decrement counter event. Let's do a hard restart and test. Let's press the plus button first, then the minus button. First, 1 is displayed, followed by a 0, it runs sequentially the way we want it to. In the to-do app we'll create later, you will see an example of applying a custom event transformer. With this, we learned about event transformer.